Hi students, very good morning. Today in this session we are going to read the remaining half chapter of the surface chemistry, that is colloids. That is colloids. See, it is very simple chapter. The entire thing bears upon your memory power. How much you will remember, you can do that. Okay, so substances are to be classified. Substances have been classified into two types. One is crystalloids, another one is colloids. Okay, this is crystalloid means any substance whichever, whether we mix it with the solvent. If you pass through the filter paper, then you pass through the filter paper. Okay? See, question number. It is nothing but combination of solute plus solvent. Okay? It forms solution. Right? Here also the same. Colloids, solute, instead of, okay, first let me take solute plus solvent. This forms colloid and solution. This is crystalloid solution. Okay, crystalloid solution, and this is colloid solution. See, in crystalloid solution, we call it as solute plus solvent. The same term solute is called as dispersed phase, and the solvent is called as dispersed medium. Getting it? Right. Original solutions. We are going to be getting on examples like salt plus water, sugar plus water. Okay. This is one type of solution. This is also an example for the crystalloid solution. Means water is needed. If you take one container and you keep one funnel, take one funnel, cover this funnel with filter paper. This filter paper. See, I have taken a funnel. Sorry, I have taken a beaker. Beaker is with the funnel, and the funnel is closed with filter paper. Now I am passing this solution into this one. Solvent plus water. I am using solvent plus water through filter paper. I am filtering it. Okay. What happens? Can you separate solid and water? Only water comes here. Solvent is remaining here. Is that the condition you will see? No. Solid along with water comes into the beaker. Okay. Then that is called as colloid solution. This whatever the solutions we are seeing practically in our life. Okay? The solutions practically whatever we are seeing in our daily life, they come under the crystalloid solution. Example is salt plus sugar, sugar plus water, salt plus water, sugar plus water. Okay, here something like gelatin. Okay? Glue. Something like agar solution. What is this one? Means in this gelatin is present along with the water. If you take a container, okay, taking container with the funnel, placing a filter paper. Now, if you pass the solution, gelatin is present along with water. What happens? The water comes here and gelatin gets separated. Very simple. Crystalloid are the solutions which we use in daily life. When you make the crystalloid solution to go through the filter paper, you can't separate solute and solvent. Right? If you do the same thing with respect to colloidal solutions, you can separate the solute and solvent. Okay? Right. If you see the sizes, size of this one is less than 1 micron. Less than 1 micron. And here, the size of the particles is 1 millimicron to 1 micron. If the size of the particle, okay, particle will be having size, if the solute particle is in this range, 1 millimicron to the 1 micron, then this one is a colloidal solution. If it is less than 1 millimicron, the filter paper can't separate the solution. Then that type of solution is called as colloidal solution. ग्रहण है। थॉमस ग्रहम वाज़ द साइंटिस्ट हू
solution, this one, collider solution, this is between the 1 millimeter to 1 micron. Two solutions in the
can be calculated as Brownian moment through centrifugation process. You can separate the polarized solution. Ultra multiplied also is one of the you can separate, right? And going for the paper, slight difference you can do with respect to crystalloids and colloids. Okay. These are the basic differences with respect to the crystalloids and colloids, which has been differentiated by Mr. Graham. Remember? Next, it is, you know that one is dispersed phase, this is solute condition, and another is dispersed medium. Okay? Based on the dispersed medium, you'll be having a name. If the dispersed medium is water, then you can call this aqua, salt, or hydrosol. Okay, salt is for the solution. Salt means solution. This aqua indicates the solvent. Solvent solution. Whatever the solvent is present, will be getting dispersed. So not bother with the dispersed phase. You are bothered with only dispersed medium. Suppose if it is alcohol, this is called as alcohol. Right? So what is the term? Alcohol is the term, whatever the condition you take, if it is A, this is called as aerosol. What is aerosol? Alcohol means aerosol and air means aerosol. So the solvent name indicating for the solution. Clear? Now how many types of solutions you can form? Dispersed phase can be, this dispersed phase can be gas, liquid, solid. And this one, okay, you can also do the same. But the only combination that is not possible is gas with gas. Only 8 types of colloid. If you go for the solutions, solid with liquid, solid with gas, solid with solid. Again, liquid with gas, liquid with solid, liquid with liquid. Gas with solid, gas with liquid, gas with gas. Totally, how many types of solutions you will be getting? 9 types of solutions. But if you go into this case, with respect to colloids, you will be getting 8 types of solutions, which is not possible. Gas combination with gas, gas dispersed phase with gas dispersed medium is not possible. Right? So, if you want to make so solid dispersed phase with solid dispersed medium, if you want example, something like, you will be getting gemstones. So the stones, whatever you will be taking for your fingers, right? And this one, you can go for liquid. Okay? With solid. Next, gas with solid. Like this. Liquid with solid. What you can see? It should be something like cheese or butter. What is the substance which are having liquid in this one? Gas with solid. Okay. Gas will represent something like, you can go for something like PVC stones. Okay, if you have any notes, you can go through your material. Right, next is liquid. Liquid. Okay, you are already having anything liquid. So, you take here liquid condition. Liquid, liquid, liquid. Right? So, solid in liquid, liquid in liquid. Gas in liquid. Okay? See? Liquid and liquid. These are called as emulsions. Liquid and liquid. These are called as emulsions. Example is milk. Okay? Gas in liquid. Something like foam. Right? Solid in liquid. Solid in liquid, what you can say? That is butter. Okay, let me take, I have some confusion with this one. Right, I think it is butter. Right, it is correct only. Whatever that I have said is correct. So, solid and liquid, you will be getting something like paints. Okay, something like self-fluids. Okay, students, these are correct only. See, if you take another condition like, you want to take gas, right? Gas, solid, and gas. Gas, liquid, and gas. Soil will just accumulate smoke or dust, liquid in gas, it is something like mist or fog, and gas in gas condition. This is not possible. Okay? These are the type of colloidal solutions what can attain. So, soil is solid gemstones, a liquid is solid, cheese, butter, as well as we have known something like gels. Okay, all gels. Right, gas is solid condition. You just know what you will be reading from your fingers. And next is solid with the liquid. For paints or sulfates, liquid with the liquid is milk, gas and this one is food. Like this, you are having different types of colloidal solutions. Right? And the solutions, colloidal solutions, we have two types based on the affinity towards the solvent. Based on the affinity towards the solvent, you can have the solution based on affinity. Based on affinity of or based on affinity of dispersed. Dispersed phase.
Stable and
extra substance and extra substance is added. It is called as, it is called as emulsifying agent. Okay, this is called as emulsifying agent. See, this lyophilic colloid is not stable, right? It is highly unstable. That one should make stable. Means from outside you should add some extra substance. Like mediator, you tell you. You know, if you add a mediator, you can make the relation between the solvent as well as the customer as well as the seller. Okay, see, if you have a seller, your customer. Okay, in mediator is a person who makes the relation between these two. So he is called something like broker, like or mediator. In the same way, this is solvent and this is solvent. These two doesn't have any good understanding. So a third substance is added. The third substance is this one. It makes a good relationship with the seller and solvent, so that it makes them stable. So that when you talk about the conversion, it is called as emulsifying agent, or it is also called as stabilizing agent. These are the basic differences between the lyophilic as well as the lyophobic colloids. So once again I am repeating, these are highly related to the solvent, this one, no? This one, these are reversible in nature. These are stable and large organic molecules will form these lyophilic colloids. Lyophobic means solvent heavy, these are reversible in nature, these are unstable, and smaller organic molecules will form this one, so as to make this lyophobic substance very stable. A third extra substance is added, that is called as stabilizing agent. Okay, or it is called as emulsifying agent in terms of emulsion. What is mean by emulsion? Emulsion is that type of colloid solution where liquid is soluble or liquid disposed to base and liquid disposed to solvent or present. Example, right? So these are the differences. And next, examples of the lyophilic as well as examples of the lyophobic. Okay? So let me take lyophilic colloids examples. Lyophobic colloids. Okay. In this, we have three. Generally, our syllabus it is three. So you remember that something like S, C, G. Okay. As you can remember it as CGS, nothing problem. SC cache is a G, or you can remember as CGS system, because I have not the type of the system where it is present. Okay? And yes, indicates for smoke. Right? S indicates for smoke, C indicates for clouds, right? C indicates for C. It is cloud. C, cloud, and G, gold. Okay? Gold solution, cloud, and smoke. These are the lyophobic in nature. And this one, see? So you will be remembering something like MBBS, right? You remove one B, it will become MBBS. So M is for milk, B for blood, and S for starch. So these are the examples. Okay, you can remember it as SCG or CGS system. Here, MBBS, something like this one. Okay, let us go for gold or smoke. Smoke. What is the dispersed phase? Dispersed medium. Type of solution. Okay, smoke means dispersed phase is carbon particles. Okay, carbon particles, or you can say something like it is called as dust. Carbon particles are present. What is dispersed medium? It is A. So what type of solution is it? Aerosol. Okay, in each condition, suppose you go for gold. Okay, dispersed phase is gold dispersed medium is water type of solution, polar solution, this aqueous. So what is the right cloud? In cloud, what is the dispersed phase? Dispersed phase in cloud is liquid dispersed medium. Okay? So type of solution, aerosol. Okay. In the same way, go for this one, milk. Okay. Dispersed phase, dispersed medium, type of solution. Okay. This is will be having liquid fat in water. So this is called as aerosol. You check your material. Will be having all these things. Next it is blood. Dispersed phase, dispersed medium, same this also. Type of solution. Right, we'll be having RBCs, something like water, this is also called as aqueous. And next we will be starch. So dispersed phase is starch, dispersed medium is water, this is also called as aqueous. Right? If there is any mistake, you can correct it. See, these are the things. You remember, is CGR, CGS system. Okay, CGS system or MDS. Milk and blood as well as the smart solutions are available and available by smoke, gold as well as the cloth. Remember, dispersed waste, dispersed medium and type of the solution water that is present in the material, right? And now, till now we have discussed only the what? Till now we have discussed only the preparation and types. Now we have discussed what is colloidal solution, how many types of solutions are formed. This is the condition. Entire colloidal we have something like five conditions. One is, what is colloidal solution? Okay, this is initial. Okay, what is colloidal solution? The same colloidal solution is the solution where the size of the particles is in between the 1 millimicron to 1 micron size, where you can separate them to compare the original two solutions. Next, how many types? How many types are there? In the form, 8 types. Next, what are the types based on affinity? Affinity, based on having two types. One is lyophilic and one is lyophobic. Up to here, we have completed. And three things are there in entire chapter. One is preparation. How these solutions are prepared. Okay? Next, what are the SPs after preparing is go for purification? This is purification. Okay? Next properties. This is the entire domain where the colloidal solution is. First you should go for the preparation. Okay? Next is purification as well as the properties. Right? If you go to this, if you come in up to here, 90% of the chapter is completed. Only here the basic chapter is. Okay, the entire question is from here as well as here. Okay, we can expect the questions. Now it is types of colloids based on sizes. Based on affinity, you have to or based on sizes. Based on sizes. Okay, these are something like that. After this thing, you can learn this thing. By that, the chapter will be completed. Right, let us go based on sizes. Based on sizes, one is multi-molecular colloids. This is one condition. Three types of sizes. Based on sizes, one is multi-molecular colloids. Means small, small particles will be present. It may be small atoms or molecules. See, atoms or molecules. Small atoms, they are combined together and they form into the size of the colloidal range. See, atoms combined form colloidal range size. Colloidal range size. And this is the formation of the colloidal solution. You have only atoms. Many atoms, they combine all together. They aggregate together. Okay? They aggregate together and they come into the size of the colloidal size. And that solution is called all, multi-molecular. Not only atoms, some waves molecules also. Molecules all aggregate together and they form the colloidal ring size and result in the formation of the colloidal solution. This is the condition. Right. And another condition is that is based on the means smaller particles are getting associated. Okay. And the next one is macromolecular colloids. Macromolecular colloids means a particular molecule becomes which is very big. If you add that one to the solvent, then it comes into the size of the colloid. So one big molecule plus suitable solvent. If you have suitable solvent, then the molecule size will come to the size of molecule comes to size of colloidal bridge. See, if we have a big molecule based on suitable solvent, if you place that, it comes into the size of the colloidal bridge particles. Then that type of solution is called as macromolecular discovery. See, multi-molecular means small particles getting attached together and forming a big size. This one, big molecules, depending on the type of the solvent, it gets the size of the colloidal bridge. Okay? Then, associated colloids. Associated colloids, right? Associated colloids are those colloids in low concentration. Low concentration, they behave as electrolytes. Whenever a suitable substance is added, dispersed phase is added to the solvent, okay, dispersed phase is added to the solvent, then that one will behave as electrolyte. When this dispersed phase is in high concentration, then that becomes as colloid. Getting me? A substance at low concentration becomes like electrolyte. When that substance in the high concentration behaves as colloid, then that type of colloids are called as associated colloids. Meaning, then that type of colloids are called as associated colloids. These are also aggregated colloids, right? So, multi-molecular, associated or aggregated. You can call this one aggregated. Aggregated or associated colloids at low concentration will behave as colloids, at high concentration will behave as colloids. From there, the colloid formation takes place. That concentration is called as CNG. This is called as critical Mitchell concentration. The concentration from there, the formation of Mitchell means association of the all particles with the colloidal cells. Okay? The concentration where the particles turn to the colloidal cells. The concentration, the minimum concentration of the solute or the minimum concentration of the dispersed phase where it changes into the colloidal bridge. That concentration is called as CMC. At CMC, the temperature, whatever that is present at this CMC is called as trap temperature. Okay? The trap temperature. The minimum concentration required for the formation of the micelle is called as critical micelle concentration. And the temperature that is existing at CMC, that is critical micelle concentration, is called as cracked temperature. So some of the properties are increased at this concentration. Okay? So generally electrolyte is not really having. Electrolyte shows conductivity. Electrolyte shows conductivity. Suppose I am taking this is below, this is critical micelle concentration, this is above. Above means above CMC. This side is below CMC. So, this is the condition what I am. This condition is above CMC and this condition is below CMC. Okay, if I talk of carbon dioxide conductivity, conductivity is high because the critical vessel concentration. When the concentration has reached to CMC and have passed CMC, above CMC, the conductivity decreases. Okay, once again, remember conductivity. Conductivity of the particles will be more below the CMC and conductivity decreases above CMC. Right? Next, there are some properties, right? Okay, we can go for the turbidity. Turbidity. Turbidity means like becoming paste. Okay? Turbidity is first, below CMC is high. Sorry, below CMC, turbidity is low. Means becoming of like paste. Below CMC, becoming paste is very low. Above CMC, becoming of paste is very high. Because all the molecules will come together and they will form a big structure. Right? Like surface tension. What happens? The surface tension below the CMC is very low. The surface tension below the CMC is very low and above the CMC is high. Okay? These are the things we can give clarity whether they are going on, going on, increasing. And there is one more property. That property is called as colligative property. What happens to the colligative property? So, colligative property. Colligative property. Here, the colligative property is very highly increased. Here, it is increased only, but slowly. At slow rate, it is increased. Highly. So, these are the factors what we will see. Right? So what do you mean by CMC? CMC is critical vessel concentration from where the formation of the vessel starts. And whatever the temperature that is existing at the CMC is called as cracked temperature. And if you take below as well as the above CMC, below CMC the conductivity is very high, above CMC the conductivity has been decreased. The turbidity is becoming of thickness. The thickness of the viscous medium. It is very low. After the CMC it is increased. Go for the surface tension. Surface tension of the colloidal solution is very low, and here it is very high. Going to the colligative property, below the CMC, it is very high rate. It forms colligative property. There is a change in the colligative property, and above the CMC, it is with a slow rate. It is incremental rate. It is increasing with very slow rate. Right? These are the general properties. So this is the word that you will be seeing, right, generic and formation of missile. Formation of missile is exothermic in nature. This one is exothermic in nature. Means the more amount of heat will be liberated, then gamma H will be equal to negative. Right? Now the action of the missile. How the missile is formed? Let us see. Missile formation. So we have something called the missile. So missile formation. This is very simple. Okay? See something, if you do a mechanical, what happens in the grease or blood will get attached to the cloth. Okay? Right. So you are taking a big container to wash the cloth and you are placing a cloth. Cloth, this is cloth and this is the grease. See, this is grease and this is cloth. This you are having attached. Now by washing you should remove this one. So I am taking water. This is water. have taken water. Okay. No, I want to do this one. So what I am doing? I'll be adding surf. What does this surf consist of? This surf consists of a substance which, see, water is polar. Water is polar means it will be getting plus comma minus charges. Getting up plus or minus charges is called as polar molecule. So if I cover this grease, this is non-polar. I can say this is organic molecule. Okay? This is grease. This is called as organic molecule. This plus or minus charges will not be getting. So we know one thing, that polar dissolves in polar, non-polar dissolves in non-polar. Chemical bonding, polar dissolves in polar, non-polar dissolves in non-polar. That's why you'll be saying, example for this is NaCl in water. NaCl is polar, water is polar, it will be dissolving. Now, kerosene, okay, in petrol. Kerosene is non-polar, petrol is non-polar, so kerosene gets dissolved in petrol. Then NaCl is polar, this is non-polar, non-polar. But if you add petrol to water, petrol will not be dissolved in water because petrol is non-polar. Okay, but water is a substance that has been here, it is polar, so non-polar, doesn't have any plus or minus charges. Water you have added, this is polar, so water is not capable of removing this dirt. Be careful, this one. This is polar, this one is non-polar, mark. Water is not capable of dissolving this one in water, in heat. Why? Because this is non-polar in nature, this is polar. Now you are adding some extra substance, which is called as surf. That substance, it has both ends. It is like this. Sound clear? See, at one end you are having charge. So this is polar. And the entire end this is non-polar. See, this is carbon. CH2. Right. Organic molecule is carbon represented in this carbon. So you are having non-polar end as well as polar end. So this polar end dissolves in water. Dissolves in water. This one dissolves in what? Grease. Okay? The surf whatever you are adding, that is having two ends. One is polar end and another is non-polar end. Okay? The non-polar end dissolves in this one. Because it is also non-polar. Non-polar dissolves this one. Polar, this one dissolves in this one. So if there is dust like this, the tail part will be here. Comes to this one, charge is here. Something like COO minus. Again, very part like this, COO minus. Formation like this, COO minus. Condition like this, COO minus. It comes like this, COO minus. It comes like this, COO minus. And this formation is called as micelle. Okay? Because this is hydrophobic part and this is hydrophilic part. Hydrophilic means having attraction towards water. This is heading towards the water, so this is called as hydrophobic part. Hydrophobic part dissolves in the grease, hydrophilic part, it is in water. So, there is a strong bond between the water as well as CO compounds. So, if I wash away, what happens? If I wash away completely, water will move away. If water moves away, then CO compounds also moves along with the water. If CO compounds move along with the water, this tail also will move along with CO. If this tail is moving, what happens? This grease also moves along with the water. So that the dirt is cleaned out. So water pull. What happens? It drags CO minus. CO minus drags what? Non-polar tail. This non-polar tail drags grease. Finally, the soil will be clean like this, without being dirty. Okay? So, this is used. The mechanism of cell is formed and how it is used in cleaning. There are many things, like example, C15H31COO-Ag. This is called as sodium chloride. Suppose there is one more thing, C17H35COO-Ag. This is called as sodium polyate. Okay, these are the soaps. Are the soaps. We can just use it to remove the oily substance or non-chloride substance that are getting stuck in the cloth. Getting in? Right? What is meant by methane? Methane formation is nothing but the reaction for increased attraction to it and it has been taken in vessel with water. This is a non-chloride substance. What is it? Polar. You know that polar dissolves in polar, non-polar dissolves in non-polar. So, what is not capable of dissolving this one to remove the mixture? So, you are adding the third substance. Consists of both head as well as tail. Head one is polar in nature, tail is non-polar in nature. So the non-polar end gets stuck onto the grease and the polar end gets stuck into the water. If you remove the water to the little pressure, the H4 drags CO minus drags non-polar end, non-polar end drags the grease from the shirt so that the shirt is clean. Right? And this is the part of the structure that is called as this end. And this is the action that you can see in the cleaning of cloth. And the methane is formed in this critical temperature. Okay, craft temperature. Concentration is CMC. We have learned this. Surface tension, what happens? Corrugated properties as well as conductivity with respect to the below CMC, after CMC. Right? Next, we will be learning with respect to the three properties, the three P's. Okay? That is what? Preparation, purification and properties. Right, students? Okay, let us start with this for today and tomorrow we will start with the three P's. Right? Analyze them, stay safe, stay home. Bye.